Game 7 here at Queen's Park, the last one in Trinidad, so it's been a big weekend of cricket. And the Jamaica Tallawahs are in town to take on the home side. Their last home game. Chris Gayle winning the toss tonight and straight away deciding to have a bowl first, which is the case mostly at this ground. They're coming off their win, one game they've played so far against the Patriots. There he is, Chris Gayle in town. They're a good side. Sangakkara, Dale Steyn. So some big overseas players have come into the Tallawahs this year. It's been the crowd, big crowds filling up. Saw a huge crowd for the double header over the weekend. Packing out Queen's Park, one of the best places for cricket. All the excitement, the fun, the noise, the dancing. And they've come in. McCullum and Amlar open the batting for the Knight Riders. Amlar already one innings and a man of a match so far in the series. McCullum yet to get going. Could tonight be his night? $10,000 US is up for you. Get onto this daily fantasy CPL game. Play On is back this year. So get on before the first ball's bowled. Pick your team, get part of it, and be in the running to win $10,000 in cash prizes. Always fun to get on. Get your fantasy team up and running. There we have Unibet, the live betting odds. Knight Riders $1.80, Tallawahs $2. They say close. Home crowd would hopefully not say close. They want a win. They want their second win, which would be a nice start. With me, Mark Butcher.
Evening, Marto. There's a couple of legends in your picture there. Kumar Sangakkara with the gloves on once again. Hashim Amla, all style and skill and calm at the crease to open the innings for the TKR. Brendan McCullum, well, he's had a quiet time of it. Quiet time of it in this competition, but also recently come in from the T20 Blast in the UK for Middlesex, where he's not had things his own way at all. Those numbers are not a reflection of the ability that this man has. Always fabulous sights and sounds and smells here at the Queen's Park Oval. But the home crowd will be a little anxious, I think, this evening. Having lost two from three, having seen their captain lose every single toss thus far, there'll be one or two nerves knocking around in the Trini posse and the rest of the TKR faithful. They need a big, big performance from their team. Guarantee you this, they will support them right to the very last ball. Imad Wazim is going to open the bowling with his slow left arm against Hashim Amla. We're just about ready to get underway here.
The Trinidad flags all flying. Chris Gayle, he's ready to go. We're close. Start game 7.
He almost looked pumped up there, didn't he, Chris Gayle? About as pumped up as he ever gets. Cool expression on his face. He knows he's got a big team. He's got a fantastic side. The roster looks absolutely superb. This could be another year for the Tallawahs. Champions in 2013, of course, playing against the reigning champions, TKR. Final countdown's on then. Game 7. Let's get underway.
straight away. Some turn. Just enough. Some Bramler. But these wickets have been good. This whole square block has been very good considering the conditions. A lot of rain's been around, but the ground staff done a great job.
Looking to get off the mark there, Amla. I just wonder whether or not the Tallawahs, coached by Paul Nixon. Look at this guy. The flash. Although I think you'd struggle not to see him.
That's his spot, Amla. Touch of width in the first boundary of the night.
Yep, close your eyes and imagine Hashim Amla at the crease. And I bet this shot pops into your head immediately. Just that little bit of width. Rocks back onto the back foot. Wonderful free flow of the arms. And unerringly, he finds the gap.
I'll just get one. Well, yes, you mentioned Paul Nixon as well, back as coach when they won it in 2013. First time they won it, playing at home. There he is on the screen. Fellow Englishman.
Yeah, and I know he's very hot on making sure that he does as much research as possible. He'll know that Hashim Amla was knocked over by left-arm spinner in the last game, Virasamy Permal. So I just wonder how much that has influenced the decision to open with spin here. In fact, he's been out to left-arm spin twice in the three games thus far, Hashim Amla. And Brendan McCullum has struggled against it too. Yep.
The roar of the crowd, McCullum's off the mark. That's the first over done, six for no loss.
Well, that's a real pirate of the Caribbean. Ahara Mahartis. Definitely putting herself up there for the hero fan of the match. Of course, all of the matches here in the CPL. Prizes on offer for the best outfits. She looks handy with that cutlass, Mardo.
Yes, all the fans around the Caribbean dressing up, getting to these games. Good prizes to be won. We've had a few superstars. Michael Jackson the other day. Superwoman. Batman, Kermit, the Cookie Monster yesterday took out the prize, which was nice. Come as a car if you want as well. Oh, spin from both ends. And you know McCullum and his trouble early on. Shakid Elsan, nine matches. Best, 6 for 6. Be happy with that. Oh, that's it, McCullum. That's what he needs, just a couple of those, and he'll be back into his groove.
Yeah, interesting. In the dismissals he's had to left-arm bowlers, he's found himself getting opened up a little bit. This time he just gives himself a bit of room, backs himself to hit it. Crashes it through the offside.
Well, I think the key is just give yourself some time, isn't it? We know what McCullum does, but this boundary, straight onto it, to hear the noise off the bat. And I think he would know that he's missed out. Every batsman wants to make runs. You feel a bit under pressure. It's just giving yourself time. And if he gets through the spin, you know at some stage they're going to be bringing pace bowling back on. And he loves the ball coming on. It's through again, same spot. Another boundary.
Yeah, the footwork is what makes this again. Okay, Shakib Al Hassan will be upset with himself for dragging another ball down. Just watch how McCullum gets himself deep in the crease. He's been going at the ball a little hard in his previous innings. This time he waits, rocks back, creates the space to get that bat through. And Shakib, not happy. Oh, he's down the track. That's huge. That's the McCullum we know and love. It's a hero maximum. Twenty for none from two.
What a start. 20 off two overs. McCullum with boundaries. Amla's got a couple. But this is the McCullum we know. Down the ground, over mid on.
Bit of gamble, wouldn't he? Bit of gamble. He knew that Shakib would have dragged a couple down. Away again here. Bristling with intent, Brendan McCullum. But he would have known that Shakib was so upset with himself for dragging those two down that he cut, gambled that the next one was going to be up there, ran at him and boshed it over mid on.
Yeah, did well. He looks determined tonight. Oh, you can't stop those. He is finding the middle of the bat at the moment.
Well, we may have had a large volume of rain here in Trinidad over the course of today, but this has left scorch marks on the outfield, hit so hard by McCullum.
Yeah, those fielders had no chance, raced away. He's going along now, 21, just up nine deliveries. Oh, he thought about it. There's a bit of the outfield, soft in patches. Just had a feeling he was coming down the wicket then. We'll just repair that. Outfield was not bad considering a lot of rain today.
Yeah, I think it's gone way beyond good to soft out there. This is exactly the sort of start that the TKR needed. Disappointing so far in their home games. Going well now. Three gone, 28 for none.
The Knight Riders, the top there, McCullum and Amla. Just one change in their side. Searles comes in for Miller. Get off to a flying start at the moment. Oh, he's gone the same spot, McCullum. Is it big enough? It is. Hero maximum. He's second for the night.
Well, this is an extraordinary shot. Shakib has actually done him a little bit in the flight here. But Brendan McCullum just keeps going with the shot. He leans so far forward, gets his weight going forward, and just flicks his hands through the ball. That's an incredible shot. It really is.
Yeah, see there, mid-on's up. They've got mid-off back, because that's where the ball's turning, but he's not hitting him there. Well bowled. We saw him get out early in the game, sweeping. We straight. He got bold leg stump. I think for me, I'd rather him go straight down the ground. Good flight, good seam. I don't like the sweep shot option too much.
No, that was never one of your shots, was it, Mardo? Taking on the likes of Muralitharan and stuff, you much prefer to play with the full face of the bat. It's clever bowling from Shaqib. He's just gone a little slower and a little wider at Brendan McCullum.
Yeah, left arm, this one was speaking about bold leg stump. Oh, thank you very much. Make it three for McCullum tonight. He's come out determined.
Well, it's raining hero maximums here. Shaqib pushes this one through a little quicker. McCullum spots it and goes, thank you very much. I'm sticking that 12 rows back. May well have bounced off the manual scoreboard here. Remember, there is a prize on. Guardian crowd catch. Anybody that can catch a one-hander in the crowd, pick up 1,000 US. Not sure about catching that one one-handed, to be fair. May well have pinned somebody to the scoreboard.
He missed it by a fair way, didn't he? Bounced off the scoreboard into him. I like that McCullum. He's hit a couple and then just take his time. That middle and leg, that's the spot. They've got off to a flying start. Now, if he stays in, just pick off a couple of boundaries and over. Another fine over. McCullum is on fire at the moment. It's four overs. It's 40 for no loss. Until rhythm section. I've got Mark Butcher next to me. He knows more about rhythm than me. They love it. They go. They just go all night. The energy. That's the one for me. Sitting on the big drum. Just banging away. Oh, they love their cricket and they love their music here.
Looks dangerous, that sitting on the drum. You wouldn't want to miss, would you?
Certainly not. Look at that. They love it. And Dale Steyn into the attack now. Good start. Debut in the CPL. Nice to see him part of the Tallawahs. We know how good he is in all forms of the game. Played on test matches, one day as T20s. Not a bad debut. One wicket last game as well.
I wonder how you feel. Dale Steyn, one of the best and quickest swing bowlers in the world. And you get given the ball after four overs. It's been smashed everywhere with the spinners bowling with it. Unlikely to swing now.
He's trying to swing it. But these are the boundaries. McCullum, wasn't much width there, but then once he pitched it up, he came down the wicket, used his feet beautifully. That one, don't even worry about your feet. That went hard and high into the scoreboard. He is certainly putting on a show at the moment. Oh, tough call. Tough call. He knows it. I was thinking good delivery, playing a miss.
Well, I think that's an error. Hard work being an umpire. Difficult. Oh, no. Maybe that's fair enough. It was an off-cutter from Dale Steyn. And it was a good 2 or 3 inches outside that line. I take it all back, sir.
Oh, a shot for one. Andre Russell, good to see him. He was off the ground last game. There was a few injury concerns, but nice to see him back out in the park. It's good to have Dale Steyn part of it. We've seen some new overseas players. Michael Hussey's playing, Shane Watson, Sangakkara behind the stumps. We haven't even got to him yet. And he's batting. The record he's got is just reeling off numbers of unbelievable figures in the game of cricket.
Certainly come alive here. They're a little subdued, a little nervous before the start. Not anymore.
Well bowled. Callum advancing. We're going to get on the ground and try and have a chat. Hopefully, you can hear us. Chadwick Walton, can you hear us?
Yeah, I'm hearing it.
Tell me, mate, how's the atmosphere out there?
Come again?
How's the atmosphere?
The atmosphere is pretty good. I mean, McCallum smashing it out right on the ground, but. Let's hope we can have him very soon.
It's through. Is it going to be enough? It is. Amla, another boundary.
Well, once again, Hashim Amla pierces that backward point area. Chadwick, you opened up with a couple of left-arm spinners. What was the thinking there?
Well, the left-arm spinners, I have run down out, I think, two times out of three games, so...
That's the first five overs done. It's 48 for no loss. McCallum, Chadwick, it's a big wicket. He hasn't been making any runs, but at the moment he's looking in good form. Oh, it's hard to hear us. Can you hear us, Chadwick?
Yeah, I can hear
you. Mate, McCallum at the moment, he's looking in good touch.
Yeah, very good, Nick.
It's always tough. Players, it's very noisy out there at the moment. We'll leave Chadwick at the moment. A few noise issues. So this crowd in Trinidad, Queen's Park. So this partnership, McCallum, he's 35, Amla's 12. He's going along just as the quiet partner at the moment. Spin's been the option. That's the way. Get McCallum back on strike. Good running.
Yeah, they're already way past their best power play score of the competition so far, the TKR. It's 39 for 2 before today. Previously lost 8 wickets in the power play in their last 3 games. So. This constitutes a really good start for them. I'm sure they would have talked about it from the last match. Munro made 100, they only made 162. Oh, got him. Got him. Quicker, flatter, arm ball from Wasim. It was an absolute beauty, and it got through McCallum before he got that big bat down.
Spinner's got him the whole series. We saw that previous one, a sweep shot, leg stump went. This time the off stump. The length. Got the length wrong. And just was swung in the arm ball. No turn. That is a big wicket. He was flying along McCallum. He's gone for 35 and it's 49 for 1.
hero from Saturday night against the Amazon Warriors, is at the crease. One Kiwi departs. A current and future one is here. Colin Munro after his 100 against the Warriors. Wasn't enough to see them over the line, but they were made in some fine style. H.D. Ackerman.
It was. He needed the runs as well. You know, when you're a new guy coming into a side, you want to make an impression. Well, he made it on the biggest stage in the most emphatic way.
Oh! It's been impressive the way this, I suppose, handball, or in the old currency, we would have called it in the UK, a drifter. One-finger ball, some people call it.
Just goes straight on, doesn't it? I mean, I suppose this one is a little bit more, it's a bit quicker than the old drifter from the 80s and early 90s.
Yeah, we saw Akil Hussain doing it the other night when the Tridents played the Knight Riders here at the Oval 2 games ago. They are in the right place in the Caribbean, so you wouldn't think it would be too much of a surprise to see the bloke behind, not the bloke in front. I don't know where he's come from, left in front of the screen. Pirates of the Caribbean. They're everywhere. No pillaging out here tonight. Not a surprise to see Munro do that either. Loves a sweep, reverse or orthodox. 52 for one.
It's a shot that he tried on a number of occasions the other night during his 100, and he failed virtually every time. When he hit the ball straight towards long off, long on, deep mid wicket, that's when he clattered it. Darren Bravo walks in next, runs in the first game against the Zooks. Dwayne Bravo played brilliantly against the Tridents. Keita Miller finds himself out the side. He struggled a little bit with spin, and Javon Searles comes in, the seamer. 52 for one after six. This is comfortably their best start, the Knight Riders. Three bowlers used, the two spinners opening the bowling, Wasim and Shakib Al Hassan. Dale Steyn just with the one. Three games, there was concern about Brendan McCullum. He walked to the weak wicket and he dominated proceedings from the word go. Use of the feet, Shakib back over his head for six. He cut the ball well. That was an incredible stroke, beaten in the flight. Amla played nicely as well before McCullum was undone by Wasim.
Too much work, that is too difficult for the keeper, but cleaned up by fine leg. How wayward was that? Not sure if it's an attempted slow ball that got away or something.
He didn't sort of try and dry his hand or anything, Dale Steyn, so just come out badly by the looks of things, unless it's slightly damp, not sure.
It's a very good start for the Knight Riders. It's their best power play score of the Hero CPL 2016. And they want to ensure that they keep a good tempo, because they were probably led by Munro very well with the bat for about 14 overs the other night and failed towards the end of the innings. And then when they come to bowl, in my view, they've been going at 10 and over for the first 3-4 overs in every bowling effort. So they need to bring a full package tonight to stand a chance.
Munro's 100 was just over 60 balls, and they only ended up with 160. So the rest of the team ended up scoring at a strike rate of around about 100, which is not good enough. Not in this day and age. So, yeah, 100 in a losing cause. From a bowling point of view, Bish, I think that the, you know, they've thrown the, all their eggs in the spinner's basket, and that they want Nikita Miller, Suleiman Ben, and Sunil Narine with their trump cards. Narine's been brilliant again. I think Ben's been below par. And Miller, well, he's been left out of this game, so it shows you where he's been.
That's a good stop. That would have run away for four. 2 yards further away from cover fielder.
It's a wonderful stroke, isn't it? It's only got in one. It's a really difficult shot to play. We're seeing all sorts this evening. Everyone is making a real effort to win that prize for the hero fan of the match.
Latched onto that beautifully. He was outside the off stump, Asham Amla, early, and picked the length beautifully. 64 for one.
It's a shot that at the start of his career he never played a lot, the pull shot or even the hook shot. He's developed it later on in his career, and it's made him even tougher to bowl at now. Boundary to end the previous over from Dale Steyn. So often we talk about bowlers utilizing the crease. Well, Hashim Amla is one of the finest exponents of a batsman that uses the crease so well. Walks across outside off stump. Steyn sees him go, so whacks it in. But Amla's up for it. Finds the boundary.
Just wondering how early he went and whether the bowler could have maybe adjusted his method of delivery, but not sure he went early enough to allow Steyn the chance for a yorker at leg stump, say. Anyway, Keswick Williams from St. Vincent and the Grenadines into the attack. Had a good game. Is he going cross seam as well? Orthodox down the line. Oh, good carry.
Short, but it just nipped away, went away from the left-handed Munro. One match, Keswick Williams, so the nerves will still be fresh, but had a good game.
Yeah, 3 for 23 over in St. Kitts, man of the match. Played for the CCC here in the Caribbean before the domestic tournament. And that is it. Top edge away for four. A few short balls have been served up tonight.
Well, why not? Because every time you pitch it up, you go back over your head. You might as well try something different. But this is the thankless task that bowlers face in T20 cricket. Whacked in, just a swing and a top edge over the keeper she goes, and away for four. It's a thunderous start here for the Knight Riders.
goes again and will get four. Not sure that Munro intended for it to be as fine as it went.
It's not that wide, is it? Munro is looking to square cut. We know that left-handers love wood. All batsmen love wood. But it's not that wide to cut, and so it is a thick outside edge, and it goes fine for four.
The slip has gone in now. Chris Gayle has positioned himself at slip. No one saving a single leg side. Trouble if he hits trouble. Hashim Amla would have been gone by some distance. Andre McCarthy was the fielder, and they might get another one. Comedy of errors.
Not good. Not good cricket at all. Gayle's facial expression barely changes, but it's not a run. And he would have been miles out. And then from there on in, it was just about sloppy fielding. Sloppy backing up, a sloppy throw from the boundary. Dale Steyn.
Unfortunate for Chadwick Walton. Almost a Republic Bank classic. You'd see him sometimes with the gloves behind the stumps, Chadwick Walton. That's a fantastic effort.
Munro advances, it's hit flat, it's hit hard, and Walton has to make up some ground away to his right, puts in the dive, and out she goes. It was out before the elbows hit the ground, though.
A scorer with a cheeky grimace that makes your hair stand on end. Change of pace, lovely. 75 for one.
You just wonder if the Knight Riders have a look at the batting lineup that the Tallawahs possess and think, well, we need to bat at this pace because we're going to have to set them something significant when they have the likes of Gayle and Sangakkara and Shakib Al Hasan and Andre Russell. That's power. There's lots of power in that top six.
Rothman Powell.
Yeah, Williams may feel a little bit unfortunate with the way the over went. I mean, the first boundary was a top edge. The next one didn't have a lot of width on it. And then the drop catch. The over goes for 11, but he can almost walk back to his fielding position and think, I don't deserve that.
Again,
now, anything you can do, Colin Munro, I can do equally as well. I'm not so sure this was a good choice of run either from Amla. Oh, that would have been tight. maybe it was the perfect judge of a single. Inch perfect.
It's one of the relative newcomers, well, certainly new to the CPL, Powell. He's about 22 years age, Jamaican by birth. One of the young guys played for the CCC in the Nagy Coast 50 over competition earlier in the year. Wasn't too bad, actually. Looks a useful all-rounder. Batted at 4 in the first game, batted at 6 or 7, I think, for the CCC in the 50 over tournament back in January, and had some good scores with the bat. It's the first time we're seeing him in the wider Caribbean context.
I love watching him field, you know. He just glides over the outfield, Andre Russell. There might have been a moment where Munro and Numbler thought, shall we push for two? But as soon as you glance and you see that man, you know it's just one. Standard's been raised tonight, I tell you what, it has been raised.
It's only for Andre Russell to put his coat on, Superman. What changes of pace. It's only early days in the tournament. Risky delivery with third man up, but it's 80 for one.
Yeah, great to see players like Sangakkara involved in Hero CPL. Some real big names here this year. Most of the big names are local chaps. Bish is the World Cup T20 champions.
I think having won the World T20 twice, no other team has done it. I think West Indian players deserve their own acclaim. We often talk about overseas players coming to add. Well, I think players can come here and learn. Players here can learn from overseas players as well. So. Take situation, quid pro quo is the term I was looking for. It's short on leg stump, you can tuck it away for one. Mid off is up, so if he pitches up off stump, it can go down the ground. Good pace, really good carry.
We didn't really see much turn from Wasim or Shakib early on. The ball skidded on, and now we've seen some decent bounce and some decent pace from the seamers, in particular Williams.
It's an interesting action. See that. Where the one is, only that.
All the pitches have looked virtually the same over the course of the four matches. Pretty bare at the ends, decent covering of grass in the middle, but patchy. But they've all played very, very well indeed. there has been a little bit of spin on offer. The biggest concern, though, has really been the outfield and the dew that has fallen late in the evening, and it's made it difficult for the slow bowlers in particular to grip the ball. But the pitchers, they've all been brilliant.
Closing the bat face there on that line, he would have wanted to go maybe the other side of the stumps where there was mid off. You might have had more value for the shot.
Big delivery this last one. They've fought back the Tallawahs. Munro's striking it at just over 110. Umla's only striking it at 100. This is a big delivery here.
Good enough. We've seen that already a couple of times from Hashim Amla. And it's a nice finish. H.D. Ackerman to the over. Halfway mark, 90 for one. And time for the Buster drinks break. 90 for one after 10 overs. And we've got a special guest in the commentary box, George Gonzalez, who is the winner of the loop voice of a CPL competition. Other folks throughout the tournament can win if you enter the voice CPL. Go to the Loop website and you too can have your moment in the sun on commentary. George, welcome.
Thanks a lot, Bish. Yep, and ladies and gentlemen, I'm live here at the Oval and very excited, and we're looking to see if the if our team could take it all the way. I think 206 is the highest score. We had it before at 170 or 180 something. Let's see if we could pass that to something mark.
And George, of course, is from Trinidad. He was born in Venezuela but lives now in Trinidad and Tobago for many years now, and a good man from the west of Trinidad. Last ball of the previous over, we saw a Hashim Amla special from that slower delivery. Wasn't tricked with a lack of pace at all, and it was a much needed boundary in many ways. Tempo had just dropped. Powell will continue. Good crowd as well, George, isn't it? All the way through this tournament so far.
Yep, well, you could depend on Trinidad for that, eh? We are the capital of Bacchanal, you know?
A generalization, because I want to exclude myself from that, to be honest.
Oh, you're not from Trinidad?
I am from Trinidad.
Well, then you've got Bacchanal in you somewhere, but Bish, you have some Bacchanal in you.
All right, I'll ask my wife about that when I get home then. But it is an atmosphere like no other when you have cricket here at the Queen's Park Oval. Generally, sport really in Trinidad and Tobago. A sea of red, white, and black. And your love and your passion for sport and cricket goes back how far?
Since I started radio, you know, when we were younger, cricket was not the game. Football was the game, and rugby. But then joining the radio station, Vibe City 105, cricket has grown on me, and now I try not to miss a match. You know, really cool. I just think that, you know, they have a four, they have a six, they should have a nine. You know, if you hit a six and it hits a three and then falls, that's six and three is nine, so they should have a nine.
Well, they've long cut down the salmon tree here that used to be where the scoreboard is located, towards the eastern side of the ground. There was a good chance of it hitting that overhanging tree, but it's no more. one of the features of the Queen's Park Oval in days gone by.
Just to tell you, I climbed that salmon tree when Pili was here. I went on the salmon tree. That's how I got in.
Giving away your age, because I don't quite go back that far.
No, my pampas got stuck in the tree, you know?
Three singles off the over so far. Short third man, short fine leg in place. It's a sort of, with the modern cricketers, and you can think of a number of players with this sort of feel who would look to play a scoop of some kind, or a little paddle shot with short fine leg and short third man. It's not something that I've seen Hashim Amla do in times past when there's enough pace on the ball. Well, Powell, your thoughts on the aura of Chris Gayle and his Tallawahs that are making this visit today?
You know, we have enough respect for all the cricketers. I just think that Trinbago Knight Riders are the best, and the rest is the rest. You know, Chris Gayle have his moments, but there's only one Brian Lara and there's only one Bravo. And when that Bravo isn't there, there's another Bravo. So, you know, I'm just saying. One have to stick to dancehall and one have to stick to cricket.
I think I'll pull your red, white and black glasses off you for the next over. 95 for one. What, 95 for one, a good foundation set by Hashim Amla. And previously parted Brendan McCullum, 35 off 18. Darren Bravo to come. And just to remind our viewers, just the one wicket he had was him, that we have a special guest in commentary with us, George Gonzalez, the loop voice of a CPL winner. And he's getting his chance to do his broadcasting and to enter the voice. Just go to the Loop website and you might get your chance. And here's another Trini, this time in the golden green. John Ross Jagasar, who made his debut earlier this year.
I just think, although we have 95 runs, boy, Bish, I think we need to do a lot better, because when Chris Gayle does come in, he's going to want revenge. So the more runs we make, is the more revenge he's going to want to get. So we need to know what we're doing, yeah?
Good bowler, John Ross Jagasar, made a belated entry into the regional scene. I think he's about 29 years of age now. Really came to the fore earlier this year when I think he wrote to the Trinidad and Tobago Cricket Board and said, look, I've been playing domestic cricket, club cricket for a while. I think I'm good enough to make the national team. He was invited to practice sessions and he did well in the absence of Sunil Narain. In the 50-over tournament earlier this year in January, he became the star performer with the ball for the Red Force team. He went on to play first-class cricket after that 50-over tournament. Worked in his father's shipping company, I think it is, for the last few years. So he's one of those cerebral guys. Feel about seeing one of your favorite Trinidad and Tobago players in the opposition franchise?
Well, it's mixed emotions, because you know you want him to do well because he's a Trini, but you don't want him to do well because he's playing against your team. You know, it's like, you know, it's just mixed emotions, yeah?
You think the Knight Riders are going well enough, George, with the bat?
Not really. I think they could do better. I just think that one person always have to pull us out of the hole, and that shouldn't be. Everybody has the talent to do the things, but it all would wait for one guy, you know, and you can't continue like that.
Pretty good lines from John Ross Jagasa. Played a lot of cricket at school, John Ross Jagasa. Comes up for the Knight Riders.
So something that my friend would ask, where's your money?
Are you asking your friend or me?
No, asking you.
Oh, okay. We're friends already. I'm delighted. And I have no money.
If you did have, where would you put it? Where is it, Bish?
My wallet. But I think they need to aim for a score here in excess of what we've seen so far, in excess of 160. Ideally, the pitch looks good. And you can see an effort to try to create some impetus from Munro. Fortuitous boundary. Another boundary of the last ball of the over. 105 for one. George Lopez here, George Gonzalez, sorry, I said George Lopez, that's a television show. Dancing girls, you think it's a huge part of the whole setup of CPL?
I think it would be a lot more exciting if they had the telephone numbers on the chest, you know?
Last ball of the previous over, I'm glad it came as well. Ran away for four. It's a great atmosphere, really is an atmosphere like no other.
Yes, it is.
Very good. Two overs for 10, 22 years of age. I don't think he's gone through the natural progression of so many young players who have played West Indies under 19 cricket. He's not one of those guys. 22, but he looks as though he's capable of handling himself. And the whole concept of the fancy dress.
Yep, it's great. People coming in, I saw the pirate downstairs.
Dropped it. Imad Wasim, the Pakistani international, has put it down.
That's the second drop in the game, as far as I can remember.
It was dare to be taken by Hashim Amla because there's no deep fielder behind point. And so he needed some more elevation, but it really should have been taken. It was straight to him. It was at a decent enough pace.
He isn't happy, is he?
I said above 160, so I think 160, 165 is the minimum that the Knight Riders will be looking at from here. Well, ideally, they'd probably be thinking something more in excess of 180 if they go well and if they finish the inning strongly.
But at this stage, I think they should start opening up because there are a lot of batting still to come.
Yeah, the two Bravos, Umar Akmal. How have you enjoyed it, George? How have you enjoyed sitting here and having your little moment talking about the cricket and just sampling the atmosphere?
Totally, totally excited. If people are hearing a noise, it's my heart beating fast because I'm sitting next to Bish and I'm on TV for millions and millions of people watching. So it's, you know, it's new to me, and I'm enjoying it tremendously, tremendously.
Still can't get it away. So you obviously, just a reminder of yours that you've had your career in radio. So this cricket thing is something that you'd probably like to do more of, or are you just happy with the taste?
Put it this way, Bish. I just want the CPL guys to know I have my visa, you know, and I could travel. I'm not afraid of planes and so forth. So let's see how that works.
But do you have your yellow fever vaccination? That might keep you back.
I have red, white, black, and yellow. Just to let you know.
Hit this in the gap. Has he hit it well enough? He has hit it well enough. So for the third over in a row, boundary of the last ball. Thank you very much to George Gonzalez for his time spent with us. 113 for one.
Well, that's a tough act to follow. Thank you very much, George Gonzalez. I can hear the sound of P45s rustling around in the back of the commentary box. Hashim Amla hasn't given up on the idea of a huge score here for the Trinbago Knight Riders. It's 42 now from 35. Pirates of the Caribbean, there are many of them here tonight, all vying for that hero fan of the match prize. And they've enjoyed what they've seen so far from their team, but they want the TKR to push on and make a total that's defendable here. They didn't manage to do that two nights ago. He was good, your co-commentator, Bish.
Yeah, he says at evening times, he's a stand-up comedian as well as a radio personality. So he's quite a flexible man, looking to add cricket commentators to his curriculum vitae. Think about John Ross Jagasa as well. He's got a delivery that goes the other way. So an off-spinner, and like many of the modern off-spinners, he's worked on having form of a dusra. Sunil Narine calls it a knuckleball.
There are already signs here that the dew has started to settle here at Queen's Park Oval. Difference in this match, of course, is that we started at 7 o'clock rather than 9 o'clock, where both teams had to contend with dew right from the off. But tonight, there was a real advantage in winning the toss and bowling first, because there is definitely going to be dew in play throughout the Tallawahs innings in the second half of the game.
Here's the one that goes the other way we were talking about. He does it well, he does it at a decent pace. Like Narine, some guys can't do that. It has to have a little bit more flight on it. Sweetly struck.
Oh, Munro is in some real form now. Talked about being nervous and being under pressure. And a couple of failures, people here in the Caribbean might not have known or seen what he could do. That 100 seems to have unlocked all of the confidence and all of the strokes. It was an absolute beauty. The old virtues of spin bowling have had to go out the window, haven't they, with T20 cricket. It's no good just to be a master of one delivery and be ultimately consistent, landing the ball in the same area, slight variations of flight. You've got to be able to turn it both ways. You've got to be able to bowl any delivery at any time in this form of the game, because the batsmen are just after you.
One 20 for one.
Well, plenty of candidates here at the Queen's Park Oval for the Digicel Bring the Beat Prize. Prize is for the best movers, the best shakers, even the best breakers. I see some breakdancing at the halfway stage. Rightly known as the biggest party in sport, the CPL. Do have to be careful, the Knight Riders. In the previous match, the loss against the Amazon Warriors, they were 102 for one in the 11th over, only made 160. That man wouldn't allow you to miss your dinner with that bell. And it does seem as though Monroe has come in and is striking at 126. Amler has gone along at a nice, easy pace at 115. Boundaries do seem to have dried up a little bit for them. And it is a star-studded batting lineup for the Tallawahs. Straight down the ground. One bounce four. Monroe's on the charge.
And I think that's necessary now with 5.5 overs to go and 9 wickets in hand. They have to start charging from this over onwards. It's too much batting power to come relative to the wickets in hand to wait for the last 5. It has to go from this over. I don't think he's primed for a scoop here.
Christopher Henry Gale. And the T-Rex is another monster. Now that is bringing the beat. We may have found our winner tonight.
I can see this going to new heights by the first week of August.
It's the Jurassic Park Oval. No wonder they went extinct. It's all too much up here. 5 to go, 129 for one.
Well poised again, the Knight Riders, 129 for one, 5 overs remaining, and they've got men in, Amler and Munro. He's found some space over extra cover, bring 2 more. Tallawahs are 4 back in the last 5 though, 39 runs scored in the last 5 overs, so they need to get a move on here.
And Munro at the crease.
Outstanding so far.
It's an incredible 100 that we all watched the other day.
Just 65 deliveries, six sixes. And came in straight away, didn't he, early on. Just took the game away. He's doing that again tonight. Maybe not as quick, but five overs to go.
What would be the number? What do you look at for the last five overs? I mean, is 10 and over? Is that what you would want, or more with just one down? Shot. Lovely shot by Umland. Only someone like Russell can prevent it from going for four.
He's an athlete, Russell. And he's doing that with, I think, a little bit of a niggle. We saw him off the park last game against the Patriots. I love Amlar when he just uses those hands and the wrists and he opens the face. And that's what's been great about T20 cricket, is the fielding nowadays has just jumped a whole new level. Each year gets better and better. You see him catching on the fence and throwing the ball back in. It's fantastic to watch.
Another bounce short. Umland moves to 48. You can't carry anyone in the field now either nowadays. Everyone's got to be able to be an athlete.
No, certainly do. But back to your mention about the score. I mean, it's hard, isn't it? You're one down. I mean, you'd want at least 10 and over. Minimum. Because you're thinking you want to get up there to 180. Around there to put pressure on Tallawahs. You just hate the finish when you're 20 overs, two down. You know, you're going along at 8 and over now. I think you'd be looking for a lot more with wickets in hand.
We certainly don't want to be two down, and then at the flash interview at the halfway mark, you say, well, we might be about 10 or 15 short.
They always say par score. I think it's par.
A vacant area now mid-wicket, splits the two, nearly a misunderstanding, but Shakib does well in the end. It ends the over 138 for one and brings up Umland's 50.
Yes, well done, Umland. Already got the man of the match so far in the series, and backing it up now with a nice 50 of 42 deliveries. Never pick him for a T20 player, but he's certainly enjoyed the competition so far. CPL.
I said 10 and over for the last five overs. They got nine in that one. No boundaries. That's where they'll want to improve now in these final four. They'll want to find the boundary, preferably without a bounce as well.
Well, it's what you've got to look at it and say, what will put pressure on the Tallawahs? I know you've got Chris Gayle there, yes, okay. If he blitzes, you know, any score is possible, but I think if you can get to that 180 mark, somewhere around there, that puts pressure on the batting lineup. So a bit of a change. Searles putting on the pads. So he's been told to get him on and maybe next in. Bravo there. Both bravos.
Well, unless they're expecting a almighty collapse.
They're lining up, aren't they? Maybe it's first out to the wicket, you get a hit.
Has he got it? Has he got it? Oh, yes, he does. What a way to bring up a 50 for Colin Munro.
That's his hitting zone, all the way out the Trinbago Knight Riders Pavilion. 100, the first overseas player to score 100 in the CPL. Now he's backed it up with a 54 off this 37 deliveries. That is his zone. He just collapses that bat leg and just picks it up. He's not even hitting right through it. He's turning into, what a massive display for him so far. It's only early on in the CPL. What can he score?
Slash the one. Down to third man, it'll just be one.
It'd be difficult to bowl to. You think, where do you go? What zones do you go to? If you get it too straight, he just scoops it away on the leg side, any width. And he hits it with power. Done so well.
I think it's the length that is the concern at the moment. It seems as though Steyn is happy to still try and hit a good length. His variation is taking pace off, but if you give Munro or Umla an opportunity to get underneath the ball, there's problems.
Well, you think you'd find there'd be a few slower deliveries in this from Steyn. But you're right, he's got to get his length right. Where's he going to bowl to Umla? He knows Umla so well. So you have a set game plan. He's moving the field around now with Gale. Fine legs back, square legs back. Four in the circle on the offside.
Straight up. Who wants it? Sangakkara backpedals. Down it goes.
Oh, difficult chance. I'd like to see this delivery again from Steyn, whether it's a change of pace. But Sangakkara, when you turn around and you're running back with the flight, you can get yourself in trouble. Yes, it's the off-spinner, slower delivery. Does Umla in. It would have been a Republic Bank classic. Classic catch, but it just went down. That's a shame there. Big wickets.
No one back on the boundary at third man. Umla's edging his way here. And that's four more.
Boundaries. Oh, they're loving it. Their last game here in Trinidad, Queen's Park. Love their cricket. Yeah, that's going to be on the boundary. That drop catch, it was difficult. Going to run back, turn around. The run's flying. We spoke about how much we thought they were going to get. 10 and over minimum.
That'll just be one. Some sanity to proceedings.
Oh, Umla, man of the match already previously. And today he came out and just good shots early. That's what he does. He bats normally from the start, and then he starts moving around. He knows what length Steyn's going to bowl. Gets across. Loves it over cover. And he's a class player to watch. It's great to have him here. And he's in form at the moment. 45 deliveries.
Got him. Steyn has Munro. Sangakkara takes the catch. The Tallawahs have the breakthrough at a very important time. 17 gone.
Yeah, it's big outside edge. An easy catch for Sangakkara. And then you walked up the Dale Steyn, said sorry. But another fine innings from Munro's gone for 55, and it's 152 for two.
Well, they'll tell you who's walked to the wicket. They refer to him as the champion. It's Dwayne Bravo.
Spider-Man. More come out. And the Cookie Monster yesterday, he made an appearance. Michael Jackson. looking forward to when we move. We see Guyana Bagonda, who's going to be dressing up, but here at the moment, it's not Darren Bravo, it's Dwayne Bravo who's came in, and the captain. He's jumped ahead of Darren Bravo in the batting lineup.
Williams. That's a great shot. That is a real good shot from Umbler. Sweet as a nap.
He does well. He works out around the crease what he wants to do. You saw in that highlights package, he went right across to Stone, but now he goes the other way. He goes outside leg. And that is just classical. And the power, look at that, one bounce and just rockets into the fence. They're going to bowl full. It's got to be right up in that block hole. Otherwise, he's going to keep hitting you down the ground straight.
Fourth, the first delivery. Pressure on Williams. To bring the new man on to strike, Bravo.
Yeah, Dwayne Bravo, the captain. And he's had that big partnership with Amla. 150 that partnership was. Match-winning partnership. They were 4 for 20. They were in trouble. They were down and out. And they managed to pull that back and win that game. So I don't think he's going to take too many deliveries to get in. We know the Bravo we know.
He walks the wicket because of the dismissal of Colin Munro.
Yeah, it's a good delivery. The slower ball again. And Munro is looking to run it down to third man. Easy nick, and Sangakkara, he'll be thinking, I've got one in the gloves. And he caught that, and then he apologised for the previous one.
Pace taken off it. He's not going to have a look, though, Bravo. He can't have a look. There's not enough time, and everyone's padded up, even Paul Nixon. Well, he's with the Tallawahs, isn't he? But he'd probably be padded up for Trinidad anyway, knowing him.
There we have. They're all lined up. Darren Bravo. Akmal. Narayan. He hasn't got him on. And Searles, we saw earlier in the stands, putting him on the pads. Well bowled. Good change of pace.
He's fought back well in this over. Williams, boundary off the very first delivery. Single, two dots and another single. Here, this becomes a very big ball for him. If he can concede a one or even a two here, it's a real win for him and the Tallawahs.
Yes, the captain's nightmare isn't the last delivery of an over if it goes for a boundary.
No, he's not. He's not. It's a brilliant over. A brilliant over. Just six from it. 18 gone. 158 for two. Two, six bowlers used. Wickets for Umar Wazim and Dale Steyn, who just got rid of Colin Munro. But an exciting two overs awaits us. Yeah, our final game here, Mardo. We're off tomorrow, aren't we? Guyana, Caribbean Airlines. Storms about. We'll be safe on that airline, though.
Bit nervous, weren't you, this morning, checking the weather reports?
You can follow your team with Cal. Yeah, I was a little nervy, but I know we'll be safe. flown on them before. Fantastic airline.
Yeah, the biggest party in sport moves. At the moment, some kids were off to Guyana. Games starting there Thursday. So, all happening. We'll see what costumes we get as well in Guyana. Competition's on.
I tell you, the standard has been set here at the Queen's Park Oval. Goes over extra cover. He plays that shot so well, Hamla, all the way. Wow, what a shot that is.
How has that gone for six? Incredible pad. I think Stain on the screen, he's saying why, how. I got it, back of a length, but as you mentioned, HD's the length, isn't it? It's probably just a touch too short for Hamla. He's got his weight going back as well. Oh, class player.
Goes again, he's caught all of it. Oh yes, another hero maximum for Hashim Hamla. Stain's getting a pasting from his countryman.
Russell, what an effort. Hamla putting on the show at the moment, back to back. Sixes, and they're going to get more than 10 over. This time, it goes outside off stump. He is putting on a batting display. Oh, I love watching Russell field. Would have been a good catch. Wouldn't have been out. He's such an athlete.
Stain will breathe a sigh of relief as he gets Hamla off strike.
Well, he's continuing that length, isn't he? The two maximums, hero maximums. This was the first one, over cover. I don't know how it got there. And then that is just pure class. Picked up off a length. He is having an incredible CPL. So far, only early on for him. Flying along, just 51 deliveries. I think he's enjoying it. Freedom.
Well, they'll have him back, that's for sure. Edge, no third man. So run down the hill and away for four. It's the big over. It's the big over that the Knight Riders wanted.
Eighteen coming from it with one ball left. So we were sitting here saying 10 over. They've got different idea at the moment. It continues that slower ball. It's a good delivery, really. He just got unlucky and the batsman won that one. And he knows it. He just shakes the head and turns around.
Now that's a shot. That's a shot that skips off the digital side and away for four. It's an enormous over for the Knight Riders. 22 from it, 19 gone, 180 for two.
And that's the over you need in T20 cricket. You get an over that goes to 20 plus and it just changes the game. We're talking about 180. They've got that. They've got one over to go. Stain, he's finished his four overs. One for 54. That's incredible. He wouldn't have those figures very often.
Final over of what has been a very entertaining innings. Put into bat by Chris Gayle, the Knight Riders. They are 180 for two after 19 overs. Hamla again in the runs. That strike rate is climbing now. It's at 145. Bravo finishes the over with a boundary. This time seam up from Stain. He had been taking pace off the ball, but continues to hit a length. But now Williams with the final one. Out. Again, Williams does the job, and Hamla's got to go.
Yeah, change of pace. Off spinner. Good wicket, too, because Hamla, he was flying along. It all happens pretty quietly. There'll be a nice standing ovation. Just the length, a nice outside edge, an easy catch to Sangakkara. It's been good. 74. He has scored Amar tonight. Class innings, just 52 deliveries, 6 fours, 3 sixes. That's 180 for 3.
No time to have a look for the new man, Searles. He's got 5 deliveries to make an impact. He's been elevated up the order ahead of Darren Bravo. Williams has been good. Last over win for 6. He gets a wicket off his first. I say this fella can give it a clout. Oh, yes, he can. How about that way to get off a mark? Oh!
Yeah, that's umpire, get out the road, please. We saw him getting the pads on earlier when he wanted to come in, and then Dwayne Bravo came in, and then Searles is coming now. And there's no time for looking at deliveries. It's just straight into it. And Amla, early on, this was the outside edge. Caught Sangakkara. Amla, nice little 74.
We haven't seen many Yorkers attempted here in the last few overs. Not one batsman's gone down and played a lap shot. Third man, no, out of reach. Stained the man. Oh no. When it's not your evening, it's not your evening.
Yeah, when the ball follows you. I think Emma almost, he's trying to place it there. He's got that natural. Sorry, not Amla, sorry, Searles. This reminds me of an Amla shot. He's going offside. And he's not happy because that races away. And then he won't be happy with this either. The fast bowler get there. Oh, no. Just kicking it into the fence. Never nice when you got to walk back and look at the captain.
Back-to-back boundaries. Easy game at the moment for Searles. Third man is back now. Fine leg up. Now someone does get on their knee. This might be leg bars. More work for Steyn. They might have a little look at that upstairs. I think he's done well. It's just whether his foot touched the boundary rope.
Yeah, good comeback. He tore up around the fence there and got down this time. Might just have a little look at it at the moment. That's where he touches the ball and where that foot is touching the rope. It's hard to tell. It's there, he touches it in the hand. Has he released it before that foot hits?
Touch and go. Give it to the fielder. Give it to the field. I'm all for a change of rule here, by the way, Motto. I think they need to make it where if the ball stays in play, it's fine. Otherwise, we rock and roll all night. 3 leg bars.
Yeah, good decision. Good effort there. He had that previous one. He kicked it into the boundary, so he did well to get around there and stop that. Chris Gale is thinking, how many does he have to get tonight to chase this total down?
Swing and a miss. Oh, here's trouble. Oh, no, it's all happening.
No, he wasn't deliberate. He looked at Chris Gale, and Chris Gale said, no, don't worry about it. Swinging himself off his feet. And then it was like mix-up. And then it was like Searles turns. No. goes to Gale, and rightly so. He wasn't intending to give him the road. He just turned around and started to run back. Okay, last ball.
Another one. Yep, gone. Sangakkara with a direct hit. Searles is gone. A dot to complete the innings. Williams did a steady job, but it is an enormous total that the Tallawahs are going to have to chase.
Yeah, great finish with the ball there. Two great slower deliveries. Play and miss. And then Sangakkara, he's done this so many times. He's played that much cricket. That's easy. Just run in and throw down the stumps. And Searles has run out. But a good total. They got sent in to bat tonight, the Knight Riders. Posted, I think. Pretty competitive score, 191 for four. It's going to be a tough run chase with that man on screen looking at him. Big thing, Sangakkara. New into the squad, Chris Gayle. I always love to watch Chris Gayle when he comes out. This crowd, you can feel it's on edge. They've only won one game at home. This is their last game here at Queen's Park, and they'd like their second victory before the teams move off.
They haven't played bad cricket, have they? They've been pretty good. But we'll get back now. Let's go downstairs now to Mark Butcher. Is he ready for us? Yeah, he is.
Yeah, I'm ready. I've got Dale Steyn with me. Welcome to Trinidad. That looked like a tough night.
Yeah, the conditions are quite tough. The outfield's quite wet. But the wicket's good, actually. I think if you change your pace, it's quite difficult. But a good wicket to battle.
You've got some fine players in your team. 191 is a tough old score to chase down, mind you.
Yeah, I think probably before my last over, we were looking good. That over just kind of put a little bit more into the innings. It's tough, you know, one or two miss hits, a little nick, and it goes to four. It changes the momentum of the game. But, you know, we've got some big hitters on our side. Chris Gayle's a world-class batter. Sanger, some of the other guys, Andre Russell. So, yeah, if we bat well, I mean, we could get this.
What about your laundry field, mate? It looked like a rugby field out there.
Yeah, the field's a bit wet. It's a bit greasy and a bit muddy. Yeah, I found it a bit tough to run in tonight and a little bit difficult to feel because it's quite sticky. You don't want to dive in with the knee. So a little misfield there, a bit of a bummer, but that's the game.
But that's all good for you guys chasing, though. Do you think that's going to make it hard for the Trinidad bowlers?
Yeah, I think so. Look, I think the wickets, the outfield is going to be quite difficult. If we bat well, and they bowl smartly, you never know. But I think if we bat well, they got 191, we got a good chance.
Thanks for talking to us, Dale.
Pleasure. Thanks.
Quite his night with the ball, but he is still a champion, Dale Steyn. What an innings this was from the Knight Riders. McCullum in the runs. That's what he's paid to do. 35 off 18. He gave them the start that was required. Umla 74 off 52. Munro 55 off 39. His form continues. Dwayne Bravo was not out 10. Javon Searles, well, he was run out with the last ball of the game. He got two boundaries.
The Tallawahs was him there with one wicket up. 18 runs off his 73 overs. Dale Steyn, that's what we talk about. Four overs, one for 56. So not a great night, but it's very rare for him to do that. Williams chimed in, one for 34, but not the prettiest bowling car, but difficult circumstances. And that's the target for the Tallawahs when they come out with Chris Gayle at the top of the order. They'll be chasing 192.